So now, if okay, important. So all of you should listen to this. Then you carry on to what you are doing. Now, I repeat. If I want to check whether Y is increasing or decreasing, what do we do? We differentiate, and then check whether is this not increasing, decreasing, but is this positive or negative? Is this positive or negative? Right? If positive, then it's increasing. If negative, then it's decreasing. So far, okay? This is what we have always been doing. Now, if I want to know whether fx is increasing or decreasing, what do we do? We do f prime x. Right? We check whether is it positive or negative. If I want to check whether h is positive or negative, whether h is increasing or decreasing, what do we do?
Dt
or dx depends on whether what h is. So the idea is this. Now, if I want to check whether dy dx is positive or negative, what do we do? Very good. We do a d square y dx square. We check whether is this positive or negative. You get the idea? So it's not so complicated after all. Okay, so let's continue with this. Now, part 3, it says 13 over 3x plus 2 squared. So, how do we say whether is it increasing or decreasing? The bottom is always positive. So you say, since 3x plus 2 squared is always more than 0, when what? Is that a condition? X is more than 0. Now, can you answer Questa's question? Can we use substitution? Can we say, let's put x equals to 1 and then find out what is f prime x. X equals to 2, put out what is f prime x. Oh, since positive, that is increasing. Can we do this?
No, I mean, but the thing is, I mean, like, I start the equation, because you see,
Okay. I'm really listening to you. Okay.
So the divide dx that I like, how do you say?
I don't
want to do
it. Okay. So the
I saw y equals 0 into the equation, then I got x equal,
what
I got?
Yeah, whatever.
Right.
No. What I mean is, she got that whatever value, right? So this whatever value I put into f prime x is still one discrete value. Now, the reason why we cannot use values like this is because there's no guarantee that at certain value, or even x can be decimal. What if x is 2.13567? Then there's no way you can test throughout the whole spectrum of values. Agree? So you cannot use substitution. Right? So in the exam, or rather in your work, there should be something like a square or a cube happening. Then you can explain easily. Cube, then it depends. Okay, let's say, okay, good question. Can I finish this first? This statement is not complete yet. So since this is always more than 0 when x is more than 0, what can we say? F prime x is always positive.
Mentioned
13 is more than 0. No need, 13 is more than 0. Yeah, but if you mention then no wrong also lah, they won't.
Why not fx? Why you got?
No, f prime x is always positive. Then fx is increasing.
Sure, but in this case actually you need to put the square on, right?
Which one?
This case, because even if you don't put the square x, it's always greater than 0.
Correct. So you hear what Ryan say?
Yes.
I don't need to put the square even, because when x is more than 0, any value that is more than 0, the itself 3x plus 2 is already more than 0. Okay, sink in already. Now, Kevin question, what if it's something like that? F prime x is 13 over 3x minus plus 2 cubed. Now, this then it depends. It depends whether x is more than 0 or not. If x is more than 0, same story. Because when x is more than 0, something cubed is still positive. But why if they didn't say?
Then
cannot do that.
Then,
equation.
Oh, x is more than or equal 0. Then still true. Is the denominator is always bigger than 0. Yeah? But then if there's a negative, okay, if this is a square and it's a negative, then it's decreasing. Because positive negative divided by positive is negative, something like that. But you want to discuss whether is there's a cube, right? There's a cube, then let's try. Let's try and give some legit number. When x is smaller than negative 4, something like that, then you can, with this kind of range of domain of value of x, then you can conclude, because when x is less than negative 4, what happened? The denominator is positive or negative?
Negative.
Then hence, f prime x is negative. Then fx is decreasing. Can follow? So if there's a cube, something like that, they will give you some workable x value for you to put it in.
If they never give the workable x value, then we just put
in our own. No. If they never give you the x value, right, then x is a spectrum of positive and negative. Very difficult to do one.
So, but then you can state that x is greater than negative 4 by yourself, right?
Can you write this by yourself? No, because question differ by question. So you cannot assume a range yourself, cannot. Usually they will give you a range. Yes. Usually they will give you a range. X less than something, x more than something. Hey, coming to this, can we also cover this concept? Can you tell me this equation, x cannot be equal to what? This is a one mark question coming in AMAX exam. I give you any equation, x cannot be equal to what?
Make below equal to 0.
You make the below equal to 0. So this is negative 2 over 3. Why? Because when x is this, then the denominator becomes 0.
Then
no use. So 13 divided by 0 is undefined. So the question will come out, state a value of x where the equation is undefined. Also, x cannot be equal to negative 2 over 3. Something like that. It came out in one of the year paper. Yes. Alright, quickly go to part 4, then we can stop the video. Part 4, it says that determine whether the gradient A is increasing or decreasing. Right? So if I look at the gradient, whether is it increasing or decreasing, you have to check the derivative. So in this case, you have to check the gradient prime, which is in this case f prime prime. Okay. So I can stop the video here.
Yeah.
Or maybe I write down the answer for f. Can you help me check your working as well?
Negative
78 over 3x plus 2 cubed. Okay, then now I got a cube already. So let's see how to explain this. Put Monisha, try.
Because the whole thing is negative.
Is the gradient increasing or increasing?
Increasing.
Is this positive or negative?
Negative.
How? How do you explain?
The negative is the whole thing negative.
Huh? Oh, the whole thing negative. Wrong.
Because
you must tell me something.
It's always positive.
This is positive or negative first?
Positive.
You understand? So how? Is this positive or negative?
Always positive.
Always positive. Because x is more than 0, ma. Right? So I put anything more than 0. Cubit is positive. You must explain the cube part first. No, you must explain it's cube first, it's negative, then decreasing.
No,
it's
must explain the cube, then why the cube is what then?
Okay, so we try. So first you must explain that 3x plus 2 cubed is more than 0. Then followed by saying that f prime prime x is always negative. Then finally you can conclude the gradient is decreasing. Can follow? So there's always this, this, and then this. The three things.
You don't need to talk about the negative 78?
It's fine because negative 78 by itself is negative. So it's a fixed number mah. But anything negative divided by positive is negative. So then it's summarized in this sentence. Okay?
Yeah.
I start the video here.
Yes.